Smart City Combo Antenna, installation instructions. Before starting, read the paper manual included with the antenna. The first step is to connect the two parts that make up the main profile of the antenna. The profiles are connected using plates and two screws and wing nuts. The plates should not be tightened too much at this point. Another screw and nut set is mounted in the second part of the profile. The second element should be connected to the first one, as shown in the video. The connection should be secured by tightening the wing nuts. It's time to attach the UHF box to the profile. The wing nut should be unscrewed from the box. The thread coming out of the box should be inserted into the mounting hole on the profile and secured with a wing nut. The attached cable should be screwed into the installed box. The next step is to install the reflector bracket, consisting of two plates and a mounting screw. The bracket plates should be connected to the profile with a screw and then lightly tightened with a wing nut, so that the reflectors can be slid into it. After sliding the reflectors into place, the assembly is secured by tightening the wing nut. It's time to install the rear part of the antenna, the dipole with a box, responsible for summing the signals from the UHF and VHF bands. Four wing nuts should be loosened to unfold the dipole and position the aluminum profiles in the recesses on the box. The loosened nuts should be tightened. The fifth wing nut should be temporarily removed. It will connect the box to the rest of the antenna. Before attaching the second box to the frame, it should be connected to the first box. The Smart City Combo antenna can receive the VHF band in horizontal or vertical polarization, depending on how the VHF band dipole is mounted. At the location of this recording, the VHF signal is broadcasted in vertical polarization. The rear box should be attached to the main profile as shown in the video. After turning the antenna, the box should be secured with a wing nut. The antenna is ready for mast installation. The installation is quick thanks to the special U-bolt. Simply place the antenna on the mast, slide the plate between the threads, and tighten the wing nuts, but not too tightly. The antenna still needs to be aligned. The antenna should be pointed at the nearest terrestrial digital TV transmitter. This can be done in various ways, for example through apps like Emimaps or DVB-T2 Finder. After pointing the antenna in the right direction, the U-bolt can be tightened, securing the antenna. Make sure that the dipole of the antenna is not obstructed by the mast pipe. The coaxial cable mounting bracket reduces the load the cable exerts on the box. Since a compression connector is used and the box is sealed, no additional cover is needed. To achieve the best possible results, a professional digital TV signal meter should be used to align the antenna. We have shown this in another video of ours. Link in the description. 75 ohm coaxial cable connected to the antenna socket on the TV will be connected via an adapter. This will facilitate the later installation of an antenna power supply if needed. Time to search for DVB-T2 channels on the TV. The receiver finds all digital television multiplexes, including multiplex 8, transmitted in the VHF band in vertical polarization at the filming location. If the TV does not have a built-in DVB-T2 tuner, an additional external device should be installed. The signal parameters visible on the TV's diagnostic screen show that the reception is very good. If the signal strength or quality is low, adjust the antenna and observe these parameter indications. Antenna selection, installation location, distance from the transmitter, and terrain shape between the transmitter and the antenna are the main factors that determine good reception. The signal parameters transmitted in multiplex 8 are also very good. If the distance from the antenna to the transmitter exceeds 40 kilometers, power the amplifier in the antenna using a power supply, which is sold separately. Installation of the power supply is very simple. Just unscrew the adapter and screw the F connector of the coaxial cable into the antenna socket of the power supply. Then plug the power supply into the socket. Activating the built-in amplifier increases the signal level by 12.7 decibels for the UHF band and by 18.7 decibels for the VHF band. If the antenna is very close to the transmitter and the signal is very strong and of good quality, the antenna can be mounted in a compact version. Simply disassemble the front part of the main antenna profile and secure the connection with the included cover. Thank you for your attention. Visit our eShop at dipolenet.com.